from Liberty Benton High School. We got high school basketball for you. A lot of basketball today. Just got to see the great game with Genoa and Oak Harbor. And it's my pleasure to bring Pat Eakin in here from the press. And Pat, welcome to the 2016 basketball season.
Hey, it's prep basketball. What could be better?
It's going to be a great game. We took the drive down here to Liberty Benton. Rossford's going to be taking on the Eagles tonight. And, you know, it's kind of that David and Goliath that you're talking about.
It's two Goliaths because you've got two schools coming back that both are co-champions of their league last year.
Definitely.
You know, Liberty Benton, great reputation statewide, state runner-up about 10 years ago. Rossford, no slouch. They bring back six players, six strong players, good guard play. And for Liberty Benton, you know, I was talking to the JV coach who was speaking Ben Vorst, Mr. Vorst here, Brian Vorst, Toby Ledesma here just a little while ago. And Rossford's got to keep an eye on Anthony Mastrolasco. And Mastrolasco averaged over 20 points a game last year. He comes back, he's Mr. Everything for Liberty Benton.
Right. Well, I'll tell you, Rossford isn't as big as they've been in the past few years, but they're very quick. Yeah, Cody Sinclair in there, of course, Perry, Ben. All of these guys are really good, quick basketball players. Everybody on Bryant's horse team does that. So I think that's what you're going to be seeing a lot tonight. A lot of quickness. And you're probably going to see a lot of turnovers, too, being the first week.
Well, you know, that's typical for first week. You always want to improve on that as the season goes on. But, you know, that's one thing with Rossford. You've got a lot of backcourt players coming back. You've got five good backcourt players. I'm sure he's going to be using a lot more guard system, a lot more quickness, maybe speed up tempo. Your big guy is Ben Verbosky.
Yep.
And we'll see what Coach Force does with that this year.
It's going to be a great game. We want you to stick around and enjoy it. Toledo Sports Network in high definition. Proud to bring you this game tonight. Welcome you here to Liberty Benton High School, home of the Eagles. Mike Jamison along with the one and only Pat Eakin. Pat, nice to see you, buddy.
You too, man. This is the game here of Northwest Ohio. You know how I know that?
Oh, boy. How do you know that?
Dave Spengler is here from DaveU1.com.
Oh, my goodness.
And when Dave Spengler comes to a game, that means it's the game in Northwest Ohio. I suggest any Northwest Ohio basketball fan visit DaveU1.com. Dave runs that site, and it's got every score for every league.
It is. It is the best. And now, with all the OHSAA mess up, or you know how they're changing their website.
Sure.
All you have is Davey. They do a wonderful job
over
there.
Tim Street has promised me from the OHSAA that the OHSAA will get on the ball. They're getting that updated. They're going to get there. But you're absolutely right.
Well, we're going to get the starting lineups right now as they get ready. You got the big guys coming in. Anthony Mastrolasco, number two. Number four, Tyler George for the Eagles. Number five, Austin May. I get a little ahead of him here. Number 22, Connor Greer. And one of the guys you're going to be hearing a lot about tonight from what I've heard. And number 40, Ethan Frankhart, 6'6 senior, and he's the big guy.
Yeah, there's a lot of size there. Frankhart, 6'6, Mastrolasco, 6'4, May, 6'3, Greer, 5'11, there's a lot of size. You know, Liberty Benton comes in. They had a great tournament run last year. They shared the BBC title, Lipsick. And, they win this championship. They dominate this league.
Oh, definitely.
They dominate this league. Now, Rossford starters tonight, Matt Fierst. How do you pronounce Matt? You know Rossford better than I do.
Fierst.
5'10 senior. Coda Sinclair, 6'1 senior. Jacob Perry, 5'9 senior. These are all veteran backcourt
players. Oh, definitely. They've been playing a while.
And you got Jackson Murphy, 6'2 senior. And big, tough Ben Verbosky, a 6'3 senior. And these are all guys with plenty of varsity experience. Nobody averages 20 points a game. But these are guys that have been on the court. They know what they're doing. And now they're moving up a step where it's all on their shoulders tonight.
Well, if you're a Rossford fan, you know with Coda Sinclair, Matt Fierce, Jacob Perry, Jackson Murphy, all of these guys can get hot and they can hit the three-pointers. And then you've got Verbosky inside that he runs the points, or he runs the post so well. Should be a interesting night on both sides of this game.
Before we get the tip-off here, I want to credit the Rossford JVs coming through a 49-28 win.
Wow.
Yeah, Coach Toby Ledesma, I tell you, this guy is fantastic. He's going to be a varsity coach somewhere. I can tell you the reasons why.
And Liberty Benton's going to take it. Oh, nice little drive inside. Frankert misses it, but they get it back outside where they need it. Oh!
That's Master Lasko. He's averaged 20.2 points per game last year. He shot over 52.9% from the field, 58.7% from the two-point line. He averaged over two steals. He does everything. He does everything. A leader in the BVC in almost every stat category, playing alongside Nathan Kraft last year, who graduates, playing collegiately now. Now it's all up to Master Lasky. It's all on him this year, and Rossford's got to find a way to stop him.
Now Murphy gets it, sneaks it inside to Verbosky, and he gets... There's quite the problem down there. Bonus there, Saints going to the Eagles.
This has become a rivalry game, too. Last year, LB won 59-56 there at Joe Stalma, on Joe Stalma Court.
It's a tough start game for both of the teams.
Yeah.
And, Liberty Benton has been pretty much what's going on in their league. And Rossford, won it last year. Oh, nice look inside all night. Oh!
This is where Rossford's got to compete. They're a little bit outsized inside tonight.
Yep. And if you look at things... Rossford's going to kind of stick in this matchup little zone that they have, and it works out. They'll get the guys on the corners, and you're going to be seeing that real good here. Almost looks like a 2-3. They move the ball well. Eagles from Liberty Benton.
Yeah, they'll take care of the ball. They'll move the ball fast. You're not going to see anybody. There's a quick foul.
Yeah, it's a foul on Matt Pierce. Oh, no, that is Sinclair. Sorry about that. Special thanks going out to IBEW, Local 8, UA50. Of course, great folks over at Genoa Bank helping to make this happen each and every, three times a week now.
And I guess your viewers just saw a good game between Genoa and Oak Harbor. Is that right?
Oh, yeah. Wow. You don't see that kind of stuff.
No, there he is again. And, he's already put up all 4 points in this game so far. And that's what Rossford's got to find a solution to that. They've got to find a way to stop him.
Master Lacos, he's in there at 6'4".
Nice drive by Sinclair. Nice movement. Nice find a way to get to the hole.
Another steal. Coda Sinclair's going to bring it. Oh, boy, he wanted that one.
Yeah, he was... He was 25 feet away from the...
Oh, come on, Dad. Can I please?
I can see 22 feet. I don't know about 25, especially with somebody that's got a little more size on you defending. He's probably saying, go ahead, take it.
Well, once you get Fierce, who's going to start driving and attacking the basket, that's going to spread it out, and that's where you're going to get the points with Sinclair, with Murphy, and... They're going to be all over Master Lacko. Good ball player, though. Is that the one that reminded you of how you played when you were young?
Number 14 on the JV. That was me. I don't want to.
I thought you were shooting for the stars there.
Numbers, I was skinny, wiry. I need to lift some weights, Mike. Good shooter, good ball handler, and I was fast, but. I gave it up after JVs. I probably could have made the varsity, but I didn't have the stellar career you did at Cardinals Scripps. I'm sorry.
Stellar.
I played with some darn good ball players, though. I grew up playing with Jim Welling and Randy Gardner.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, Bruce Speck.
Coach Force is taking a little timeout talk there with Matt Fierce. And, they need him to attack the basket. That's what he is. There it is. Liberty Benton, though, the Eagles are shutting it down real well. And they're just, you know, when they got the big guy in the middle there, Frankhart, he stops it up pretty well.
Well, you know, for a team, a program that likes to handle the ball well and doesn't make many mistakes, they score a lot of points. They averaged over 60 points a game last year, which nowadays is a lot. I mean, you equate that to, I'd say, 30 years ago, that's probably more like 70, because in my opinion, the scores are lower today because of the three-point shot. Believe it or not, a lot of people don't understand that, but it's true.
Jacob Perry with that three right there. All last year, I called him the garbage man. He always figured out a way to find something. Perry was the garbage man, and he could always make something happen. Got a foul, and Rossford's going to get it back.
You know, you got to have a garbage man every
year. Oh, yeah.
That's,
eventually, we'll get our internet feeds working and working flawlessly. We're using a whole brand new system. Everything's in HD now, so every week it's something new, but that's okay. Ben's got the ball now. Get it out to Verboski outside, and you know he's got pretty talented with shooting out there too. But you want to see him?
Well, Verboski—that's a Rossford name, boy. That dates way back 50 years.
That's a foul.
That's days I remember in the Northern Lakes League. That Verboski name back when the Rossford had the good teams that dominated the Northern Lakes League in the 60s. There was always a Verboski on that team.
All the time.
Matter of fact, the team that went to state, I believe, in 66, I believe, there was a starter, Verboski. Probably, I'm sure. I guarantee you there was. Somebody could probably hear in the stands right now. State runners up, lost to, I believe, Dayton Chaminade. Class double A.
68?
69, maybe? Yeah. It's been so long ago, I can't get the exact year. Well, it was quite a ride for them, though. Then they lost to New Lebanon Dixie with a Class A a few years earlier.
You cannot give him that much time. Masalako, you just do not give him that much time.
Yeah, he's got 6 points already. Rossford's right in there, down 9-7. Hanging good. With a team that just dominates this Blanchard Valley Conference in almost football, basketball.
You're
it's
right.
been going on for 20 years.
Yeah, right. And like you said, you know, this is that area where people are, they're moving
well,
out
this
here.
This is suburban Findlay here.
Yeah.
I mean, every time I go out, there's more houses.
Perry with a little floater.
Findlay Liberty Benton. There's a reason Findlay's a mailing address here. We're just, you know, a mile off 75.
Sure.
I mean, just a mile down the road is Findlay High School, a couple miles. Then you go west a ways, you got Columbus Grove about 20 miles west here on 12, and that's getting into my family's territory, Van Wert County.
All right, you got to like what you're seeing from both of these teams so far. They're dedicating a lot of their time getting the ball inside, and then freeing themselves up so they can get those threes outside. So far, really impressed either way.
Yeah, I am impressed. Got a 9-9 tie game, 2 minutes to go, and we're in for a ball game, Mike.
Perry.
Yeah, he turned it over. I've seen these officials before. I've seen them work the NWOAL.
Oh, yeah.
Seen them at Wauseon. You got some competition there in Wauseon. Did you know that?
Oh, we got the Wauseon playing Genoa next week.
Well, you know, I don't know if that Wauseon crew realizes it because they're really homers. It's a cable access station. But all Northwest Ohio is getting their games.
That's good.
Maybe somebody needs to tell them that.
You trying to tell me I got competition? Is that it?
There's the Wasion cable access. Was it WINT or W? And they do a great job. It's fun. I watch a lot of their games, but they don't. You know, I live in Perrysburg. I'm watching their games. I think the only people that see their games are living in Wasion.
Well, I think that's always been one of the big things of what we're doing here with Toledo Sports Network. I mean, we're on 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 different networks. I mean, it's amazing. DirecTV, yeah. Channel 14, Time Warner.
Yeah.
You know, Buckeye, right over the air. Put a paperclip in the back of your brand new $1,000 TV. Boom,
it's CW 13. It's all Northwest Ohio, part of Southeast Michigan. It's a nice market. I'd like to see some, you know, that's why I say it's nice to come out here, because there's a lot of leagues and programs
and
out here that
us.
Ought to get involved. They ought to get involved. Oh, sure they do.
Yep. We'd love to. We need to get some sponsor help so we can come and do it.
I'm waiting to come out here more. I'm waiting to Northwest Conference, NWOAL, you know, whatever.
These gyms are just so
more.
Big and dedicated, and
this gym is known. District tournaments here.
Oh, I like the spin right there.
Yeah, nice move by
Lucas Warner.
Yeah, 6'5", 255 pounds, just throwing his weight around inside. Rossford's up. They're doing a great job. There he goes again. Master Lasco.
How do you stop that, Pat?
Well, you know, he's close to done. He's got 8 points right now. I don't know. You know, I think Coach Forrest.
Just let him have it.
You know, there's not much of a scouting point at this point, report. So, you know, I think, you know, there'll be some adjustments made. It's the season opener. We're not seeing a lot of turnovers, Mike, like we thought.
Nope. 20 seconds left in this first quarter. Murph, a little early in the set, I think.
Yeah. That was the ill-advised shot.
That's a walk.
Gosh. Oh, I don't know.
That's a walk.
He took both pivot foots and took them off. I'm sorry. I'm sorry,
beautiful
BBC officials. You are, yeah.
But
kind of blew that one.
Walk. That was a walk.
He had both pivot foots without dribbling.
We were talking about that last night.
Yeah, there's Coach Vorst talking to him. Oh, so how many pivot? How many times does he get to do that? He gets to rotate around and do cartwheels, I guess.
Oops.
Yeah. Oops. Yeah. And you're giving a foul, too. It happens. You know, I did that. I officiated 6 years. Remember, I did the Blanchard Valley Conference. And I'm glad nobody recognizes me here, because I haven't gotten beaten up yet. So I did the BVC, and I can still hear. I got a feeling I wasn't very good, according to what there's.
Got it.
Oh, yeah.
How about that? You know, that's the kind of stuff that you expect from him. And he did a real nice job bringing it down to a one-point contest here in the beautiful, beautiful facilities here. And, Pat, we got a good one for you here. When we come back, second quarter action right here on Toledo Sports Network and CW.
Ever drive around the neighborhoods just to look at the houses? I like spotting the ones that have been around the longest because they remind me of the amazing legacy I'm part of.
Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank.
For over 110 years, our bank has helped families buy and build their homes. And all that time, one thing hasn't changed. At Genoa Bank, we believe that when we put the mortgage needs first,
the rest takes care of itself.
Genoa Bank, taking your banking needs personally.
On the job for you for over 100 years. You need a career. You need a future. Local 8 can help you make it happen. Join the men and women who build our community. Become a part of a proud tradition. Build your career. Build your future with the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local Union 8. We're on the job for you.
We're on the job for you.
Conveniently located in downtown Rossford, Ohio, the law firm of Heben, Summer, and Murfree is there to serve your estate, business, and litigation needs. Heben, Summer, and Murfree is a proud sponsor of Rossford Athletics. Contact the law firm of Heben, Summer, and Murfree at 419-662-3100 or on the net at www.hsm-law.net. Go Bulldogs!
And we're ready to start the second quarter. 14-13 Liberty Benton right now, on top of the Rossford Bulldogs. Our 9:30 contest. Don't forget, tonight, 11 o'clock, we've got the Rossford girls taking on Ottawa Hills this week. Myself, along with Pat Eakin here, IBEW, Genoa Bank, UA50, helping bring this game to you. Oh, a steal right off the bat.
That's complacency for you. Now Liberty Benton's looking to pressure. Well, that should wake up somebody.
Yeah, those are the kind of things that you just don't want, you want to see early like that.
You know what? You see things like that. You go to the state tournament, nice. You see things like that.
Nice.
It's crazy.
Go to Sinclair, 2 for Rossford.
Bulldogs are playing a good basketball game here. And I got to think by default that LB's a favorite in the BVC. They got to be. I mean, that just every year. Sorry, Van Loo and 10 other teams, but LB's a favorite.
And what division are they in, too?
They're Division III. They're the only team in their league. I'm 99% confident of that. Only team in their league. All the rest of them are Division IV. They had BVC added North Baltimore and Hopewell Allowing a couple of years ago. Real nice additions. I think they tried to get Columbus Grove to come in, but they've stayed in the Northwest Conference, where they've been for a long time.
Gotcha.
With Convoy, Crestview, Spencerville, Lincoln View, Paulding. But Lipsick and Liberty Benton were the class of the league last year. Arlington finished in second. Had a good season. Van Buren and North Baltimore had good seasons, winning seasons last year. Top five teams last year.
Got to be careful inside there. Shamad Smith. I can't say that. How do you say the last name? Boucher? Benton's tough. Great defensive pressure by the Liberty Benton Eagles right there.
Yeah, this is what they do. I mean, these guys know how to win, and that's what Rossford's up against. And, you know, I see Northern Buckeye Conference schools coming out playing these kind of programs, and they've got to live up to and face up to it and play to the same level.
Kind of career, they get it back over to the man tonight. So far, Anthony Masurlaco.
You know, it's kind of like I'd watch Northern Lakes League teams, you know, go out to play Napoleon, and Napoleon kids, they just play so hard, and they just give everything they have, and that's what you see. And you just got to be able to match that.
Now Verboski gets it out to Ben.
Nice move by Sinclair. Oh, he got blocked. Shot blocked by Connor Greer, the little guy on the team. Oh, is that offensive?
You go.
Yeah, there you go.
There you go.
Nice setting up, getting position for Connor Ben. Senior, that's a kind of defensive. You know, when a guy does that in the first game, I tip a hat to him.
Oh, yeah.
Because, you know what? A lot of times you see guys kind of scared, a little timid to do that early on in the season.
Especially when a guy's towers over you like that.
Oh, yeah, and he's coming right at you, and you're going to just stand there and take it.
19-15 is your score right now. 5:28 left to go in the second quarter. IBEW, Local 8, UA50, Genoa Bank, helping bring you this game tonight. We can't thank them enough. You know, Moe's over there, too. Had a Moe burger today. It was some good stuff. Nice. See, this is where the quickness comes in. There you go.
He was hacked.
Yeah, Verboski's going to go to the line for
hacked,
two.
Hacked by Clay Leonard, a senior. Both these teams have a lot of seniors.
Well, and you're seeing it, too.
They look like this isn't their first game.
Yep.
Grand Vermilli at the line. Or no, wait, I'm looking at the wrong team. Verboski, who am I sorry? I like to switch teams on you once in a while, Mike, just see if you're awake.
Are you telling me I'm getting old or something? That's what you are, aren't you? You're telling me I'm getting old.
I'm older than you. You didn't notice.
Pat's telling me I'm getting old.
You didn't even notice my facial hair, did you? Here, my beard.
You know, I kind of got that a cross between Blake Shelton and Dolly Parton. You
got the statistician Jay Pilkington. He's got a beard here too.
How about that one's going in?
St. John's went to St. John's, played tennis, right, Jay? Played tennis at St. John's, right?
Tennis is one of my favorite sports.
One of his teachers there was Ed Heinschel. One of his favorites, he says.
Austin May. Along with Tyler George up top. They're just kind of taking their time. They're trying to set up for that three. And there it is. No, didn't get it that time. Greer. But boy, that one's there. Greer has hit a couple of them tonight.
You probably didn't know, Mike, that Ed Heinschel was an East Sider.
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Yeah. Hey, us East Siders stick together, buddy.
All right, okay.
You better watch it.
All right.
Yeah, he's a great guy. Perry inside, gets it back out to Coda Sinclair. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh, that's the same guy. He's just hacking everybody up. Connor Greer.
Yeah, let's give it. He tripped, and we'll give him that. He tripped over that one.
He tripped and they ran into him.
Yeah, either where was he going? He had nowhere to go.
You know, that's the way you get a foul. You move around, and I don't know.
That's his first foul today.
Yeah, they're in there. They're in the bonus already.
Yeah.
Wow.
And this is where.
And we're on the road with BVC officials, man.
4:10 left to go in the second period.
You don't see this every day.
Got to make them, too. You need these.
Right, look at this student body here from LB. Look at this crowd we got here. It's a beautiful facility.
They're here to see your facial hair.
Yeah.
You know, I got to say something like that every week.
I think they are.
Got them both.
That's what they came for. LB up by 4. Oh, my gosh, a great idea.
Yeah, that was
great
a nice idea.
I mean, just somebody.
I even flipped cameras on that one. I wanted to make sure.
Yeah, right? A good idea. Keep transition game going.
Well, you got to be fast now. You've got the bonus, and you're going to need it because these guys are shooting the lights out.
Oh, all right. There you go.
Go to Sinclair with that.
Pass. Yeah. Steal, I guess you call it. Off the rim. Boy, finding a hole. Yeah. Okay.
That's exactly what Coda Sinclair
does. Coach Ben Durkin wants a timeout. Northwest Ohio and prep basketball. You know, I grew up with Randy Gardner, and he was a big influence on me. My dad and his dad were administrators, took us to a lot of games, the state tournament every year, and you get kind of addicted. Plus, you got to admit, my family, too. I mean, my mom's from – my parents are both from towns with successful – high school basketball programs. It's in my family. Convoy, Crestview, Wayne Trace, Van Wert, Lincoln View. I mean, that's my dad's high school. All three have won state championships. I can't say that for a lot of schools, every school, at least in the NBC. So, it's just kind of something that, like Dave Spengler, it's a similar thing. And I think, you know, it's high school sports is just one of those things you just get addicted to.
Well, we're loving it tonight here. Liberty Benton has been just great to us and all the people in Findlay area, Dr. Todd Leslie. And when you're watching this, we've been down filming a wonderful alumni Detroit Red Wings that we're going to have for you on Toledo Sports Network on CW13 here in next week's show. So Sinclair's starting to light it up a little bit here for Rossford.
Speaking of the Red Wings, salute to Brian Smolinski from Genoa, Cardinal Stritch grad.
He'll be there.
Being inducted into the USA Hockey Hall of Fame. And there is a feature on that in this week's press. So I'm giving a shout out.
What do we miss here, Pat?
Well, you got a turnover. Offensive foul on LB.
Gotcha. Tied up ball game
and
here.
That's 18 fouls on LB, only 2 on Rossford right now. Tied ball game, 2.5 minutes to go.
Just amazed how quick this thing's going, too.
Rossford's playing well. I, for this guard setup and this setup they have. Very athletic. I'm really impressed.
I think Sinclair's going to get called for the foul.
You know, Eastwood's a preseason favorite. They haven't won a title in 6 years in the NBC, but you got Coach Todd Henlein back at Eastwood this year. But I tell you what, you can't count Rossford out. Don't count Lake out.
Nope. Lake's supposed
Don't
to be
tough. Don't count Lake out. Lake is going to be good.
Well, we have the pleasure of doing these games for as many of the NBC schools as we can. Talk about it all the time. Just need your support and some help for local. I mean, this isn't a big company. This is me, Pat, Mick, a bunch of guys that works out of my house as the garbage man's going to do it up.
Oh. Boy, I tell you, that's a desperation foul. I mean, hey, you're not making a layup on me after you just have you just intercepted my stupid pass.
And you don't do that to Jacob.
Nah.
Quietest, nicest kid you'd ever want to meet, but don't want to light that kid's fire. Put a little arc on that one. First of a lot of games for Rossford this week because they got Northview tomorrow.
Yeah.
Northview lost last night, which was Thursday night.
Yeah, and Northview had an impressive season last year. I was really – it's nice to see Northview coming back in some of the money sports, like basketball, boys basketball and football.
They're all going to Central or St. John's.
Well, that's the way it is with all the NFL schools. Maumee. I mean, Maumee. If Maumee and Anthony Wayne and Sylvania schools, if they could keep all their kids, I mean, those teams. God knows how good they'd be.
Austin,
Rossford too.
Yep, Austin May with that three-pointer, and then Fierce comes back and pops two in.
This is good basketball. Good. This is the best high school basketball I think I've seen for a season opener.
And it's in HD, so we even look better.
Oh, well, yeah.
There he is again. Pull off that time. Oh, nice.
Nice rebound.
Get
nice
out of there.
Rossford's playing smart. They are really impressing me.
Boy, that kid's quick.
Oh, you're going to call traveling? Okay. I can't see his feet from here. I don't like it when an official calls traveling on a fake. Now, granted, if he's moving the feet, but I watch officials, and some of these officials, they're not looking at the feet. They're just seeing the fake. Those feet got to move too, you know. Fakes are good things. Don't call traveling just because a guy is puts on a nice fake. Nice pass by Sinclair underneath the Shaman Smith Weiss, a 5'7 junior. I mean, he's in position. The littlest guy on the court scores inside against an LB team where every player's except 6'2, 6'3 or taller except the guard. Counting down 5 seconds. Nice pass inside, but missed the bunny. And the little guy gets a rebound.
Wow.
That's halftime, Mike. And then Rossford's ahead, 27-25.
I'll tell you what, we got to see a lot of what we thought we were going to see. And some, Anthony Mastrolocco, tell you what, they figured out a way to stop it.
Yeah.
But now you got Greer and you got May. You got some three-pointers.
Matter of fact, he came out of the game there. I didn't check his foul situation. But he came out of the game, and he's only got one rebound. He's got two rebounds. Rossford's out-rebounded. Get this. Rossford is out-rebounded. A taller LB. They doubled him up on rebounds.
Wow.
2-1 on rebounds in Rossford's favor.
That's what's going to happen. That's Brian Forrest's team right there. That's the kind of things that he's able to do.
And you know who's leading Rossford in rebounds right now?
Huh.
The 5'7 kid. The junior. Shamon Smith-Geist.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, that's some good stuff for you there. We got a couple of commercials. Once again, we do these games. We don't work for any of the TV stations. And everybody laughs at us because they say, we've never heard of anything like this. You guys work out of your freaking garage, basically.
Hey.
And you can do a great job. And Pat does a wonderful job. Everybody does a wonderful job. And a lot of love right here, folks. And we appreciate you watching tonight. And, we'll be back for the second half right here on CW13 and the Toledo Sports Network.
Wayward Bar and Grill, Shrye Road in Rossford, has your favorite foods and fun 7 days a week. 35-cent wings every day and great food and fun drink specials to tame the mightiest hunger. Watch all the games and all the events at the Wayward Bar and Grill. And on Friday nights, a special replay of the Rossford football games immediately after the game. Burgers, 35-cent wings, pasta, pierogies, and much more. An outdoor patio with TVs and great people. Stop out today to the Wayward Bar and Grill. Great food, great drink, great people. The Wayward Bar and Grill.
They'll probably make a bid at All-State honors this year, but right now the Bulldogs are up by two, and they're doing what they have to do.
Concentration, back door is going to work really well for Rossford, and quickness. We're seeing that already right now.
Yeah, you look at the ball movement. You're seeing a complete change here. They're playing they're like you said, the Rossford's in the matchup zone, and Liberty Benton's going to try and counter with quick ball movement around the perimeter. And, you know, that's how you win ball games. You don't dribble. You just keep that ball moving.
Exactly.
It's like I was watching the JV game, and that's what Rossford was doing in the second quarter. Rossford took a big lead, and they just started dribbling the ball in the second quarter. Everybody's starting to do everything by himself. And Liberty Benton came back, got within 1 point at halftime, but then I'm sure Toby Ledesma took those guys in halftime, says we got to start moving the ball again. You're not, you know. And they came out and just blew Liberty Benton out in the third quarter.
All right, Cody Sinclair right there for the Rossford Bulldogs, taking that lead back.
You know, the best teams always move the ball well. Always move the ball. Quick passes. Just
ball
keep
confidence.
That ball moving. Yeah, you know.
They know
put,
where they're going
to be. Put the ball on
be.
The floor. There's a time for that. You know, in the zone, you do want to penetrate the gaps, but
a little too much for Jackson Murphy right there for the Bulldogs. Cody Sinclair, kind of little rush of adrenaline there when he threw that thing there. Early in the third quarter here, 6:53.
Yeah, let's see what they do here. See if they start to try to get that ball flying around. Don't waste any time. Come through. It looks like Rossford's in more of just a straight man now.
Yeah, I think that's right. You got a guy cheating down low. Verbosky's cheating down low. So that doesn't happen. But
yeah, and there's the big guy, 6'6", Ethan Frankard, just a hook shot.
You cannot stop that.
No, it's a lost art, you know. Yeah.
You cannot stop a nice hook shot.
No, Coda.
Brian Myers was Brian Williams actually was my coach in high school along with Kevin McQuaid. And they both taught me how to shoot a hook shot, and I can't thank them enough. I can't do it now because both of my rotators are torn, but.
But you still play, right?
I do. I play a couple days a week over at the Family Center in East Toledo.
No, it's ill-advised. Oh, nice. Getting back on defense.
Yeah, Murph was right where he needed to be.
Yeah.
Very good stuff. Slowed that thing right down.
Now, he was a football player, and I'm looking at him now, wasn't he?
Who?
Wasn't he, Murphy, a big-time football player?
Jackson Murphy still is a wonderful golfer, and he won.
Okay, that's how I know the name, yeah. That's how I know the name, yeah, you're right.
Incredible golfer.
You're right, he is. We have to invite him to our golf league, Mike.
He can be my new partner. Okay. Dave Truman doesn't want to be my partner anymore.
Well, Dave's going to get somebody else.
Yeah, I know.
He's tired of golfing with you.
I know. Oh, nice. Cody Sinclair gets it in Verbosky's hands for the Bulldogs. Boy, Jackson wanted that one. Now, see, I would be getting that ball right into Verbosky right there. Well, not now. It was there. Throw it over Verbosky's head, make him go get it. Nobody was behind him.
Being patient. I like that a little bit. You know, I mean, they're a straight man, too, it looks like.
Yeah.
A little bit. A lot of help, though. Like,
oh, definitely.
Vice versa. I want a link on there to davey1.com.
It will be there.
Okay.
You promise you'll remind me because you know how dumb I am.
Dave Spengler. He's sitting right down there.
Okay.
And like I said, when he's at a game, that makes it
That's big.
And that's all Northwest Ohio. He will go to the Northwest Central Conference. That's Mansfield. He will go to the MAC if he has to. Wherever he goes. And by the way, they got three teams in the state football finals this weekend.
Incredible.
I don't know how to do it. I can't figure it. I don't know. It's the beef down there in Auglaize and Mercer County. It's that I just don't get it.
I do. I think the parents down there have a little bit more control than some of you get to get up here where they're not playing those video games. You know, you got them out there, working around the yard and keeping their houses up and then making them eat what there's to drink your milk.
That might be.
I don't know. That's just me being old-fashioned. Yeah. That's my grandpa Lefty talking right there.
Yeah.
Lefty Vasco, if you ever knew him in East Toledo, he's a great guy. Oh, he walked. Of course, the mayor. I got the mayor and Rex Huffman sitting right in front of me here. Neil called that before they did. Hey, you made the big time. Both of you guys made the big time now. All right.
That's the mayor. Oh, no.
Yes, you got to be good, Pat.
No, I don't know. Now I'm self-conscious.
Nice move. Pulls it back. Coda has a great way of going left. And that time he was able to turn it back around and fall back and go right. Roboski's on the floor, and I think they're calling that one on him, Pat.
Yeah. I didn't get a real good look at it.
I didn't see him do it.
Yeah, he didn't get set, but, nobody did. I mean,
it's one of them things your
Austin
legs
May,
get
Austin
up.
May just cut through that lane like it was butter, and nobody was there to stop him. We needed somebody like Connor Benn standing in his way and taking the charge is what we needed. You're talking about the NBC. I mean, Keith Lyons, the new coach at Lake, and like we're talking about, they are going to be a contender. You know, Eastwood and Janot will be there. Rossford, I can't tell you a whole lot about Otsego right now, but
they're always tough.
Yeah.
We're going to do our best to make sure we get at least.
You know, Coach Bostor's got a good team. Oh, my God. There's another one. Just complacency.
Oh.
Not paying attention. That one's on Sinclair. That one's on Coda too. Yeah. And they gotta play four quarters here.
33-30 Liberty Benton right now. Tight game, 3:51 left to go here in the third quarter, but you're right.
You know Elmwood's gonna be there. And you know what? Fall Story players are here. Did you know that?
Oh, tonight?
Tonight they're here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
How about that, Connor Benn?
Nice pass.
Gotta like that.
Nice move by Connor Benn. 5'10", going to get up against those trees inside.
Another great golfer, too. Dad helps us out here. Anything under the sun?
So where do they golf at? Belmont or somewhere?
Yeah, they're at Belmont a lot.
Nice. Wow. Nice left-handed layup. Using that left hand.
These little runs.
Now, I don't know why anybody wants a number zero, but we see it more and more. We even see double zero now on rosters. And, when I was an official, I mean, you had to do this when you signaled the, you put the fist up. And
Cody Sinclair, nice defense right there.
All right. There we go. I think the Bulldogs are, I think the LB's getting a little bit.
That's up.
From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's, 419-698-1641.
4-point lead right now, and I'll tell you what, it's just that little garbage stuff, and that works.
This is Rossford basketball, as
exactly.
I remember it.
Always.
The way it should be.
Yep, always.
Just
because they never had the big guy.
Yeah. This is the way Rossford basketball is. There you go again. I guess I don't know. I'm guessing he kept that.
No, I'll give him that
there.
One.
I'll give him that one.
Masalako. We haven't heard much from him lately. First part of the game, he was just on fire, and they've
and
been
he still
able
has
to
just 11 points. He hasn't scored this half.
Right.
6 minutes into the half. Matter of fact, Coda Sinclair is outscoring him. He now has 12 points.
All
leads
the way.
Everybody. Oh, he's fouled.
That's
baseline. On the floor. Yep.
Nice
once
move.
Once again, you got more fouls in Liberty Benton than you do Rossford. Four. That's a four-team foul. Gets the Eagles. Just one on Rossford. On the road.
Yeah,
on the road. That tells you that you're playing good. Now, these are good officials. I've seen these guys 100 times. I can't tell you all their names. I can try, but I'm not going to. But I've seen them, and they're good officials.
Well, if you're Liberty Benton right now, you have to have patience. I think you're seeing, and even with Masterlocko inside, he's trying to get things done when he doesn't need to. And,
nice.
Boy, he just got popped,
yeah,
too.
Nice
Anthony
pick
just
too.
Got
and
one.
That should be a foul. That should be
yeah,
a foul.
See,
you know,
that didn't need to
when
happen.
I played high school, when I played basketball, I was told if you set a pick and a guy runs into you, that's a foul. That's one of the reasons you do it.
Right.
And I don't ever see a call.
No.
Oh, they just can't even make a bunny.
That's the hardest shot in basketball right there. There's two of the hardest shots in basketball
nice
right there.
Nice to play by Ethan Francar. Playing hard inside, not giving
wow.
up on it.
I'm going to call that one on Matt Fierst right there. And
here the LB acting like, you know, okay, about time you called a foul.
Well, it goes. It goes,
it goes
both ways.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you right now, Anthony, Masterlocko, he is a hard guy to keep hold of. He's
yeah.
moving constantly.
Yeah.
Well, and that's the problem.
Yeah. And he's got to be an All-State candidate.
But definitely.
Rossford's doing a good job tonight. And that's what Toby told me tonight. He says, I don't know how we're going to stop him, but Coach Force has a plan.
Bringing it to a two-point game right now, and it was a nice look inside. That's
this
the
game,
kind of thing.
Oh, nice feed.
Right there.
Nice feed by Colt. Connor Benn. Nice pass inside. Moving in, cutting in.
Warner,
6'5", Warner, big man in,
yep.
inside.
He doesn't miss many of them inside.
Oh, well, there's another foul. They're caught. Now they're evening up the score here on fouls.
I think they're gonna. That's on Ferris. That's like his. That's his third foul here.
He's coming out.
Has to, yeah.
But you know, you bring in Shaman Smith Geisen, and I tell you what, he had a nice second quarter.
Yeah, Geisen is a ball player.
Oh, he got fouled there.
Well, there's the guy you want running it.
Bad pass. You're out of control. Nice feet.
Beautiful.
Nice feet.
Textbook.
Warner to Sinclair inside. At, you know, how'd they lose track of Sinclair? I mean, he threw the ball out. He's cutting underneath.
Yep.
He was, you know.
That was your inside. That was your outside guy who brought the play down and made it happen.
Yeah, he brought the ball down.
Good stuff. Austin May's going to hold it up here for the Eagles with 11 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. Quick game. Way too early, but that's now he's.
Moe's Place, downtown Rossford, has the best burgers in town and much, much more. Stop by for their famous Flaming Moe Burger. Moe's Place, proud to bring you Rossford High School Sports. At Maumee Bay Turf Center, we're on your team. Providing quality stadium surfaces for area high school stadiums and the preferred product of the NFL and supplier to the last four Super Bowls and the NFL Hall of Fame. Your sports field construction specialist and a proud sponsor of high school sports in Northwestern Ohio.
Fourth quarter's just about gonna happen here. IBEW UA 50, Genoa Bank, of course Wayward Inn, Moe's Tavern. Great people helping us out here. Heben Sumner and Murphy. I guess Sumner and Murphy. And Ken Murphy's a good friend of mine. And Jackson, his son, is playing well tonight for the Bulldogs. And Pat Eakin, like you said, 8 minutes of we're going to see some great basketball.
I think everybody has played well on both teams. It's just been an incredible basketball game. Sinclair leads all scorers now with 14 points. Just an incredible basketball game. The Bulldogs are up by six. The first non-league is a real test
yep.
for both these teams. Rossford didn't have a lot of non-league wins last year, though.
You know what? They won the conference, but they started off kind of crazy. But they got Northview. They've got this. They've got some tough stuff.
That's a nice schedule to start out with.
And that's Coach Vorst does that for a reason. Mr. Ben.
Yeah, when you're coming to Liberty Benton and you get them on your schedule, you know, that's saying something. That's LB showing you respect too. Yes. We want to play you because this is where Aaron Kraft played. This is, you know,
his sister.
Yeah, and his sister.
And we did a lot of her games when she was playing Lake.
Yeah.
In the regionals.
Yeah. And I mean, you know, Aaron Kraft had an incredible career with Ohio State. Just an amazing basketball player, drew a lot of national attention.
Looking inside again, and it's...
That's Master Lasco has not scored this half. First chance to put points on the board, 11 points, and the average 20.2 points per game last year. He actually scored, ended the season,
beautiful,
averaging a point more than Nathan Kraft, who was at 19.3. During the regular season, Nathan was over 20. But wow. Master Lasco came on strong at the end of the tournament, and finished with a higher scoring average than Nathan Kraft.
Keeping everything real tight here.
And you know what? I don't see any Krafts on any rosters here, so I don't know if they're out of Krafts or what.
Out of Krafts.
There's none here, not all the way down through the freshman. Which LB
nice
did win.
Luck.
Oh, boy. Nice shot.
Oh.
That was from 23 feet.
Warner with the rebound had it knocked out of his hands, but he must have knocked it off his foot. 43-37 right now.
Now, if I was Tyler George, I would not be taking my time bringing that ball up the court.
Well, no, I think they...
There's plenty of time left, but, you know, I don't know. You know, I don't know what the strategy is. I know coaches that like that. Personally, I don't know. I mean, I know coaches, and I know they like that guard just walking up.
That was Connor Ben's first foul. These touch fouls, all of a sudden, boom, the touch fouls. That's where you almost want to call a timeout and say, hey, that's what's going to happen. You got to be careful. Don't take super chances when you've got that going, you know?
You know, it's funny. LB put the pressure on full court there in the second quarter for a while, and then they had to take it off.
There you go. See, I like the fact they got Perry on Master Lacko now, because the quickness factor's right there, and Perry's not going to let anything happen out there like that. Oh. There you go. Finally.
That is his fourth. That's his fourth foul.
Wow.
He's having a rough first game, and he'll learn from it. He'll learn from it.
I
hate to say this, but when they get in the BVC, they're going to have their way.
They
own it.
They own it.
And there's going to be some competition. Lipsick gave them some – I don't know what the league is up to, top to bottom, and they may not be the favorites this year, but they're going to be, I can safely say, upper division.
Well, Coda Sinclair's going to run the point here right now. Oh, I love it.
Block.
I don't care.
Block. Nice block.
You know what, though? I don't care.
Good strong move to the basket.
The biggest guy, Lucas Warner, doing a turn and deciding to take it, and he had defenders. Yeah.
But nice response by Austin May, giving help, coming
keep
over.
Keep doing that, Mr. Warner. That's a big guy telling you to keep doing that.
Yeah. Matter of fact,
no point guard would ever say that to you.
Well, they've got a chance now to do some things. Master Lasco's out of the game.
Oh, there
nice
it is.
Pass. Oh, my God.
Did you see the timing on that?
Yeah.
That was all timing.
All timing. They've done that all night. I think Ben Gherkin's had enough of this.
A rewarding career begins with an apprenticeship in the piping industry. Our state-of-the-art training facility, combined with on-the-job training side-by-side with a journeyman, delivers the experience needed to become a professional plumber, steam fitter, or HVAC service mechanic. Avoid costly tuitions and student loans. Earn a competitive wage and college credit in an exciting trade. We are the Northwest Ohio piping industry, building the future through dedication, knowledge, and expertise.
Yeah. You like that idea? You live right over there. You could go have a cold iced tea or something with Mr. Jameson. Talk about the good old golfing days.
Okay.
I like that.
Oh, okay. All right. That was a nice move to the basket by Clay Lenhart, 5'10 senior.
And I get it.
Off the, a nice cut, pass, over.
Yeah, Verbosky's got to get over there.
Yeah.
If he's going to move with him, he's going to get dinged every time.
It was a nice backdoor cut, getting open, and nice, nice feed, nice read.
And guess who's in the bonus now?
No, they're not yet. Well, technically they are. Yeah, they will be the next foul. I mean, there's six foul team fouls. On Rossford, LB's got one to give.
Got them both.
So we can't, you know, say there's a disparity this half. LB's going to the pressure again, which backfired for him. He's got, I don't know about that shot.
Yeah, I didn't need it.
About that shot. I mean, if he'd have made it, but I mean, I don't know. And there you go. There you go. Now we got a three-point game. Right now. I mean, they broke the pressure. They got the ball down the court. I just don't know about that shot. Just, I mean, it was open, but it wasn't necessary. I heard a whistle.
There was a foul on the floor.
On the floor, but that's one to give, so it's still Rossford's ball. But, and here comes.
They got Fierce back in.
Fierce back into the game. Three fouls. Only one in foul trouble for any kind. You got Master Lasko with four, and Tyler George, the 5'11 senior guard, with three for Liberty Bat. Also with four is Clay Lenhart, senior. Also, I got considerable playing experience last year for the.
Force has got a small team in there right now, but they're so quick. Ben?
He's got to make that, though. Nice rebound. See, that's smart.
Yeah.
A long 3-point shot. You know, he had that, you know, he knew where that was going.
Yep.
You know, that's just basketball smart right there, getting that rebound.
That's my Freddie Sanford award going out there.
He was out there heading that way before that thing got to the rim. He knew where it was going. And that's where most of those shots are going to go. Got to make those.
Yep, they got to have that.
Start missing bunnies like LB was doing.
Oh.
Nice steal.
They got some numbers now.
Oh. Nice steal by Jacob Perry. Man, you're right. He's a garbage guy. That was just nice. Aggressive defense.
Jacob E. Perry. His mom, Lisa, always laughs at me when I call him the trash man. That's going to be a slam.
There you are.
Yep.
Still 2 points. You got to give them to him, though.
Yeah,
nice.
That was nice.
Nice.
That was beautiful.
Nice read on that pass. Nice. Just. Those are the kind of plays you remember, you know.
Bench's Greenhouse and Nursery in Elmore, Ohio is a proud sponsor of Northwest Ohio Athletics. Our spacious greenhouse area has what you need for your outdoor beautification projects. With great specials and those hard-to-find plants, shrubs, and trees, Bench's Greenhouse and Nursery takes the guesswork out of planning and maintaining your favorite garden and more. Bench's Greenhouse and Nursery. Call them today, 419-862-3596.
You know, be aggressive still. Stay aggressive. But, you know, and then you got to finish your shots.
Exactly.
And, you know, you can't let the pressure get to you.
Oh, Ben. All the way, and that goes.
He went on the floor. No, it's a foul. He's shooting. 1-on-1.
Wow. No continuation tonight either way.
There's not such
either way.
Not supposed to be such a thing in prep.
I think that's, they don't
That's
do
the
that.
NBA.
That's old-style basketball, right?
Well, it's the NBA.
Okay.
Yeah.
I never hit the NBA, so.
They got a lot of crazy rules that we don't have here. This is the front end of a 1-on-1. See, there's another thing. They are just opening this door right now. And Liberty Benton, they're just giving Liberty Benton all the momentum and confidence.
And they don't need to shoot out there, but Greer will.
Nice
rebound. Need that.
Nice rebound.
You need to get that ball into number
Connor
two there.
Ben in the right spot. Oh. Yep. And that's, is that, how many is that on Tyler George, that's his fourth. That's three his players fourth. With four. Three starters with four fouls with 3 minutes to go. Master Lasco, he's out there with four. And all of them are out there, too. All of them are out there. He's got three guys on the floor with four fouls.
We have a packed house here at Liberty Benton, and Curtis Sinclair got the first one.
That's 15 points. He leads. He and Master Lasco each have 15 points, top scorers.
Must need points for the Bulldogs right here.
Boy, Master Lasco gets another board. He's got five rebounds in the night.
46-44 right now. Bulldogs still on top. Oh, boys, that's a nice quick move.
Oh, beautiful defense. Good defense.
Take Pearson all the way. He will not stop.
He will not stop.
That's just his mockery right there, man.
He will not stop. Oh, it's a long one. Oh! Austin May brings it back to within a point. 2.5 minutes to go. LB just keeps coming back. This is when Rossford's got a match. The kind of bat, and they're not doing it. They're making mistakes. The Eagles take a one-point lead. And you're seeing turnovers, and you're seeing Rossford's in a situation now where they've got to respond now.
2:05 left to go. At this point, we got a. You're a Bulldog fan right now. What you have to do is realize they're going to attack. Eagles are going to attack, and they're not going to hold the ball when they get it. Not a foul. Wow. Wow. And that's not a foul. Okay.
No, it's not a foul.
Okay. Wow. You just get a little weird when with 1:41 left.
Grabowski's limping a little bit. I mean, he took a hard.
He got clocked.
He got clobbered there.
Yep.
He's just trying to walk right now.
And they got to keep him in there. They need him.
Yeah.
Adrenaline will kick in. Sinclair, got it. And one.
Nice drive by Sinclair. Just going after his man in a one-on-one situation. Beating him to the right side. No defense there. Just beating him. That's something that I'm sure Ben Gerken's going to be talking to the defender about, you know, not letting that happen. Not making free throws. They are missing free throws.
Oh. Wow. Beautiful move inside.
Liberty bends up by one. We got down to a minute here, Mike.
Never fails. We always have all these like barn burners. I think when we bring the TV cameras, the kids just play up a level. 51-50 right now. Liberty Benton on top. 52 seconds. Oh, there it is. Boom.
Now, Rossford needs to stop here. We might get a timeout here, too. Yep, there it is. Timeout. Get the ball across court. Timeout. 38 seconds remaining.
We're like the giant oil source for North America.
You know, I want to go to Kaleida, to Ottoville. I want to go to Old Fort. If you're hearing me and you want your game... You know, I mean, I know the only bad side is somebody gets a scouting report. That's
all. Yeah. Oh, early, but.
Oh, that's a foul.
Yeah.
That's five. That's five on Master Lasco. Yeah. That's his fifth. He's out of the game. That was not it. I guarantee you that was not it.
And you got Perry at the line. Garbage man ready to hit a couple.
And he does not.
Wow.
And how many free throws has Rossford missed here? That could be their downfall. That could be their downfall.
Second one. Good.
All right, you got a two-point lead. Oh, all right. Well, I don't know what why Sinclair just gets called for a reach and it puts Tyler George in the line. I know Tyler George is one of their, he was their top shooter last year. He 41% from 3 points. Made 45 three-pointers last night. Averaged two a game. Well, that was Austin May. I take that back. But Tyler George, I know, is a shooter, but
oh,
he missed.
Oh, my goodness. And a foul.
And now Sinclair's got poked in the eye or something, and that's third on Connor Greer.
Win or lose, as a Rossford fan, I think these teams, team has shown.
Now, are you a Rossford kid? Does you live in Rossford now? Or
no, I like all the NBC teams. But these kids, you know, we've kind of grown up with these kids, and there you go.
Okay, he needs this one right here. And this puts him at 18 points for the night. He leads all scorers, having a heck of a game with Cody Sinclair. Misses that one, though. Keeps the door open, one possession game, 20 seconds left.
He did.
He traveled.
He did. He
wow.
did.
Now, that's a turnover for the ages right there. And now, okay, I don't know. Who's got, anybody going to call a timeout here?
There's your timeout.
These kind of games against, I mean, really good opponents like Liberty Benton. Solid programs, storied program like Liberty Benton. I mean, in the districts every year. League championships year after year.
Got it spread out. Oh,
no.
There's a three. Looks.
Ties the ball game with 9 seconds left. We're looking at possible overtime as Rossford can come up with a final answer here.
Dan R's Automotive Service Center, 4041 Navarre Avenue, has been servicing the area since 1981 for all your automotive service needs. Dan R's Automotive Service Center, world-class service, hometown people. 419-693-6141.
Boy, Oaks need to answer. 8.9, see what Coach Borch has had two timeouts to draw something up here.
Do not want to go to overtime here. We are going to overtime, and folks, we'll be right back right here on CW13.
Big box stores. Choose Gladio.
A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned.
Is your roof past its peak? It's not always this easy to tell. From rooftops to foundations, Seagate is a trusted A+ BBB accredited business and a Platinum Preferred Contractor. As a Platinum Preferred Contractor, we offer one of the country's best roofing warranties, the Owens Corning True Protection 50-year warranty. That's material and labor. We've earned your trust for over 30 years, Toledo. Call Seagate now.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
Well, Liberty Benton is going to be without their 6'4 senior Anthony Masterlasco.
Yep.
see what the Eagles do to compensate for that. They've got plenty of talent out there, that's for sure.
Greer's inside, lefts it in.
You should never get a baseline drive like that.
Not to the left.
Yeah, I don't know how that came so easy. As it almost looked like Rossford is tired. And, you know, that can play a factor when you get in a game like this.
Yep.
Nope.
Ben's going to get it back and get...
Hammer.
Whoa.
Oh!
That could be trouble.
Boy, I tell you.
Ethan Frank are right there and...
Yeah, there could have been a foul called at this end here, too, I think. But the foul was called, and it puts Verbosky at the line. And he's in a double bonus here, two shots.
They're actually not even showing Ethan up on the board right now. Or am I missing it? That's his second foul. Must not have any points.
Well, they should have the starters up there, and they don't. They don't have it. Maybe they just, maybe they don't. Look at that. I mean, Rossford is just missing free throws.
Yeah. We've had a lot of them go bad tonight.
You know, he's having some issues because he's, ever since that play in the fourth quarter where he was down at this end, he got hammered. He is not. Bulldogs are down a point now. And we're down to the 3-minute mark.
I think at this time you move that ball around. You got a lot of guys on there that can catch that ball, get a minute off the clock if you're Liberty Benton. Greer does a nice job up out at the front along with May. Tyler George. Don't. Yeah. See, I don't.
That's a nice rebound. It's unbelievable.
I just don't get it.
It's unbelievable how high Connor Benn gets up there. I mean,
yep.
You know, we're talking about how they're outsized this game, but you know what? I've seen small guys that can get up as high as anybody. There you go. He's fouled on the floor. That's a double bonus again for Grabowski if he can... keep his focus here at the free throw line.
Well, get yourself to the line, take a deep breath, and I think he knows what he has to do. Got it.
And that puts him at 7 points for the night, and a lot of, majority of them are free throws.
Took the lead.
2.5 minutes to go in this extra bonus period.
57-56 overtime down here at Liberty Benton.
And last year, Liberty Benton won 59-56.
That's a nice shot, though.
Come on. There's got to be a foul there. I don't know what you're waiting for.
I don't get that with 2 minutes left to go in a one-point game, though.
Yeah, wasn't necessary. There's plenty of time left. I don't know. I just think he was just responding to the miss. I think when a guy makes a miss and he just has this thing where he just, I got to go after and get the guy. Yeah. He's got the rebound. I just got to get him. I got to get the ball back and shoot again. I can make that shot. You know, it doesn't work that way.
Go to Sinclair. There it is.
And Morris wants a timeout. Oh, he did want a timeout. He's not getting it.
No, he's getting it after the shot.
Oh, okay.
If.
Sinclair, 20 points on the night. Puts Rossford up by 3 with 2 minutes left in the overtime. Same, a nice steal. Oh, fouled again by Tyler George.
Wow.
That's his 5th, and that's 2 starters out, 2 big-time starters out. Their top 3-point shooter, top one of their top shooters in the team.
5'11 senior guard, gone. So Liberty Benton's really getting down to where they have to use their bench.
Yep. And we are going to have to apologize either way on this one. We're going to have to really cut this one short at the end because, you know, I've got time constraints here, and we're probably cutting some stuff up here to make this happen right now. But just a phenomenal game. Cody Sinclair, what a way to start the season off.
That's a game you don't
want. And then they got to play tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's good. I like it. You know, back in the old days, you always played Friday, Saturday night. You didn't play these Tuesday games and stuff. I mean, I'm talking about a long, long time ago. I'm talking about half a century ago. But, you know, that tells you how old I am. But
Peach basket. Missed them both.
And they just keep opening the door. And they got a chance for a transition to tie the game here because they're missing free throw. Oh, he double dribbled.
Is that the second time Greer's done that tonight? Remember, it happened early in the game? Was that Greer?
I missed it.
Or was that Austin May? It might have been. Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, that's that's pressure, and LB's folding a little bit. Both teams are making pressure mistakes now.
First game.
You know, we weren't seeing them tonight, but we are now.
Right.
Plus, you know, you got a little bit of that wear. You're a little tired. It's a long game. Like you said, Rossford's got to go to Jerry Sickler Court tomorrow and play Savannah Northview.
And Jeremy McDonald will have his team ready. Good friend and great coach. And, it's amazing. Most of these guys that are coaching now are people I've played basketball with. All night!
Oh, how's he miss a bunny like that?
135.
Vorst wants a foul. Oh, he's calling a foul at this end. Okay. All right. Well,
who's the foul on number four?
It's on Verbosky. His third. But you know, that puts them in a situation where they're shooting. They can't put up a three. Clay Lenhart at the line.
Oh.
And they're just, boy, I tell you, this is just
nobody wants to win this game.
This is the ugliest part of the game. This is after a great basketball game.
Well, it's like going to prom with you, Pat.
Yeah. Well, what's funny is, like I said before, we had the same score we did last year, only 56, only Rossford's up this year.
Do you ever drive around the neighborhoods just to look at the houses? I like spotting the ones that have been around the longest because they remind me of the amazing legacy I'm part of.
Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank.
For over 110 years, our bank has helped families buy and build their homes. And all that time, one thing hasn't changed. At Genoa Bank, we believe that when we put the mortgage needs first, the rest takes care of itself. Genoa Bank, taking your banking needs personally.
On the job for you for over 100 years. You need a career. You need a future. Local 8 can help you make it happen. Join the men and women who build our community. Become a part of a proud tradition. Build your career. Build your future with the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local Union 8. We're on the job for you.
We're on the job for you. We're the local IBEW.
Great basketball game from front to finish, and it's taking a huge wear on these players. It's the first game, and it's...
All they got to do is hold the ball. They know... That butter.
Why? Oh. He was open.
Don't need it.
Now he opens the door. You know, I'd almost rather see that than a turnover.
Yeah, that's true. But you're moving the ball. You were having some good time moving the ball right there.
Yeah, you force a foul.
Oh, he walked.
Oh. Yeah, called to travel. That's the right call. That's all right. He got the ball hung up on his hip.
Yep.
I'm glad because I was afraid there was might call a foul and I didn't see it. Now, Rossford's got to be smart here. I know that we're seeing some stuff going on here. It's not exactly smart by both teams, for whatever reason.
There it is. Take your time. Let some clock bleed off here.
Rossford's got to be a winner here. They got to learn how to win.
There's that foul.
Yeah. They've got to be a winner. They've got to learn how to win and say, we're winning this game. We're playing Liberty Benton, but we're winning this game. We are the team that needs to win, that wants to win.
Matt Fierce at the line right now.
You know, you might be playing Cincinnati, you might be playing Cincinnati Bowler, but you know, you got to think, you got to be confident. Say, we're winning.
That was a good number right there, a 4-point lead.
What's that about? Timeout.
From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's. 419-698-1641. Conveniently located in downtown Rossford, Ohio, the law firm of Heben, Summer, and Murphy is there to serve your estate, business, and litigation needs. Heben, Summer, and Murphy is a proud sponsor of Rossford Athletics. Contact the law firm of Heben, Summer, and Murphy at 419-662-3100 or on the net at www.hsm-law.net. Go Bulldogs!
A rewarding career begins with an apprenticeship in the piping industry. Our state-of-the-art training facility, combined with on-the-job training side-by-side with a journeyman, delivers the experience needed to become a professional plumber, steam fitter, or HVAC service mechanic. Avoid costly tuitions and student loans. Earn a competitive wage and college credit in an exciting trade. We are the Northwest Ohio piping industry, building the future through dedication, knowledge, and expertise.
Matt Fierce has his second free throw after the timeout. It worked. 4-point game. You need two right now. If you're Liberty Benton, you need two. Jump ball.
Well, where's it go? It's Rossford.
Connor Bin
with a rebound there. Tough rebound. I mean, they're boards. I mean, Rossford is out-rebounding Liberty Benton this game.
29.4, 4-point game. Rossford on top, 60-56. Overtime.
The Bulldogs outsized are out-rebounding the Eagles.
Yeah, just let them keep it. Let them keep it. There were three fouls there. That messed up Liberty Benton. They wound up losing another 2 seconds because he should have gotten the foul on the first hit.
Yeah.
Next week, we've got three basketball games for I know we got Genoa Wasi on. It's going to be a great game. And I'm pretty sure you're going to have to go to our website and make sure.
You can't make a free throw. Connor, just make a free throw, okay?
Yeah, he's too close. That's a problem.
Yeah, he needs to make
a three-pointer.
He needs to step back to 19 feet, 9 inches.
Back it up a few feet. Yeah. He'd be all set. It's a big one. There it is.
That's huge. 5 points, 20 seconds remaining. Liberty Benton just about threw it away there.
Don't foul. If you're a Rossford Bulldog, you're screaming, don't foul. Let that go. Let it go. Let it go.
All right. Timeout. Coach Gorkin.
Down to 8 seconds here.
Yeah, it's still open to a one-possession game. And we saw it happen in regulation.
Coach Morse is the best at these situations. He knows what he's doing. And you're basically going to need a quick foul. You got to have all your hands people in right now. All your hands people in. Wow, 15 minutes on this. This is not good. How am I going to do this? First week of the season. I'm in where I don't have enough airtime. First week. It's almost kind of good that we don't have a lot of commercials to run. Eight seconds. Cody Sinclair is going to bring it in. Gets it to Fierce. You know what? They waited on the call then. Yeah. Another half a second went off. That's half a second is huge. Three-point ball game, 61-58.
All Matt Fierce has to do is put one in the hole here, and I think the Bulldogs will be in very good shape.
Yep. And we do want to say thanks to Jay Williams, his son Jason Williams, doing our camera tonight. Wonderful job.
Oh, still can't do it.
Wow.
If he doesn't make this, I mean.
Coach Forrest has just got to be.
He's got, yeah. There's going to be a free throw clinic on Joel Stommel Court here, I got a feeling.
Yeah, I'm gonna say that they're going to be shooting more than their share of foul shots here at practice this week. Got it?
That is huge.
Pat, when we come out of this, it's going to have to be an ungodly quick wrap-up. Okay. Give me a quick thing of scores. And 6 seconds left. Liberty Benton. There's a long touchdown pass. It's fine. That's fine. Don't foul. Let him hit it. That's game. Wow. Folks, we can't talk long. Pat, I got to say, wonderful game tonight for the Rossford Bulldogs. And I think what we were able to see is just some incredible defense and making a lot of things happen. We got to wrap this one up quick.
Well, the good thing is the Bulldogs put three guys in double figures. Cody Sinclair scored 20. Jacob Perry had 11 and Connor Bennett had 10. And you've also got Verbosky with 8 and Jake Perry is 7, and it's just an all-around good game for the Bulldogs to get that first win over a good program.
Folks, we got to wrap this one up quick. We're way, way, way over time. Thank you for watching, and we got some great games for you next week. ToledoSportsNetwork.com, IBWUA50. Great people over at Genoa Bank helped to make this happen, and all our great sponsors. Thank you very much. Got a great game for you right now. Rossford takes on Ottawa Hills in girls basketball. Good night, everybody.